My name is Miguel, and today I'm gonna make for you salt fish stew piece, or codfish stew piece. So you're gonna need about 1/2 pound of codfish, 2 pounds depending on how much you want to use, 1/4 cup of broad beans, 1/4 cup of kidney beans. You can use 1 cup to 2. If you're using 2 cups, use 1 cup of this, 1 cup of kidney, and 1 cup of broad beans. You're gonna need 1/2 chocho dice. Spring of thyme, small or medium to me, onion, turnip, small tomato. Garlic cloves, about 6 to 8. 1/4 teaspoon of grated nutmeg. Pepper. This one's spoiling. Scallion. 2 stalks of scallion. And coconut milk. About 4 cups of coconut milk. Or less. 1/4 teaspoon of oregano, 1/4 teaspoon of marjoram, both of those are optional. 1 tablespoon of dried parsley or fresh, 1 tablespoon of dried basil or fresh, 4 whole cloves, 1 teaspoon of rosemary, grated fine, 1/4 teaspoon of pimento berry. No salt. Several salt. And although I'm using salt fish, it's vital Rastafarian food. And I'm not gonna put any dumpling in this. 1 tablespoon of olive oil or coconut oil. First thing first. Measure it. I'm using 1/4 pound of broad beans. No, 1/2 pound of 1/2 cup broad beans and 1/2 cup of kidney.
Stone. I first made my base and get some stone in it.
You're gonna tell me that this is not intentional? And it weight, you know? To have a weight. Properly. A lot of people don't realize now, but this is dirty. Look here. Wash it until this is white and pretty. The broad beans. of water. Can't get over them storing at first. The supermarket that I bought these in, I never trust them. Some supermarkets are not to be trusted, period. While some will do tricks. You see, since doing my website, jamaicadinners.com, I've been to every supermarket in Kingston City. And trust me, although they are all have everything, it's not all of them have fresh things. Alright. Yeah, since doing my books, I learned so much about food. Stuff that a typical person wouldn't think of. And most of the bad things have to do with supermarket and the meat area. That's where you gotta be extremely careful and selective on what you choose in the meat area, poultry, chicken and all them something. So just allow these to soak for about an hour, 30 minutes at least. This is gonna burst. I believe it releases the gas. I'm not sure if it does, but it's gonna burst. It's a sign. I just can't get over them stone here. Then imagine it, the whole pack. I don't imagine how much stone is in it. That is just a small amount. It's like half a cup of kidney beans. These were in the kidney beans. And imagine the whole pack that they're selling. Probably half a head full of stones. And these don't look like income from Jamaica, you know. A lot of times, like yam, yellow yam, it's a gamble to buy coconut. It'd be really skilled to choose one that's not bad. It's not sour. I'm trying to look to see if the coconut good first. I'm gonna look to see if it's good first before I drink that. Oh wow. Oh, pinch me. Well, it's obviously good. Start taking these apart. This is easy to come out, this one. You gotta be careful. It's like I don't like using this knife, you know. I like use a dollar knife. Safest way to sometimes is put it on the surface and just do this. Alright. Rinse this off. This part, but you know what, sometimes I bought the coconut milk in the can once to cook a soup that I was doing, and then I'll tell you no lie, I'm not telling you any lie, the coconut in the can is just a little bit too greasy or whatever. So for this recipe I recommend that you do your fresh one. find a new natural organic brand, if anything. Put some water in it and just dice it some. Or dice it up in this. Just be careful because it's nice, it's kind of sharpish. Younger, and they're gonna blend coconut. They used to slice it thin and then cut it in little squares. I like what the difference is. It's going in a blender. The blender is gonna break it up. Just want some small pieces. Alright, this is a small amount, so I probably can put all of it in it. Stress how much coconut is good for you. Trust me, there's scientists are finding out more and more, because one time they used to say that saturated fat in coconut is not good for you, and now they're saying it's the best thing. Squeeze this and throw this out. Put some muscle in it, squeeze it. My videos are not for people in a hurry. Cooking, you can never be in a hurry. So you never see me make a 15-minute video unless it's a short video. Unless the cooking is short. So all the other people, they hurry up and get to this part. These are the most important part, the preparation. Because I see how people, a lot of y'all are not clean and, you know, keep your area clean and things that you use are clean and so forth. So I'm showing you these stuff so that you know that's what you're supposed to do. So I've seen it. They don't take as much pride in the preparation. They're more to take pride in the cooking. Anyway, that's it. Now, let's see if we can pour this out, please. See if that's possible. Right, just put this in the fridge until you're ready to use it. Part of the cooking, I add two in the second part of the cooking. Let's remove these one leaf. I'll rinse those. So put half over here, half over there. We're gonna dice it, but we're gonna rinse it first. It's gonna dice, but we're gonna rinse it. Ginger, cut to half of one finger. And this might sound strange, but sometimes, you know, a little of the dirt from the peeling the ginger, a little bit. So they don't have to rinse it, just peel it and put it in. Garlic. Let's strip these. Can't elaborate much, but when I find out more, I'll let you know. Notice in the wild, some animals and birds, a lot of animals, eat clay. Why do they eat clay? One, I think they say it's for salt. Most of the time when they eat the dirt, it's to get the sodium from out of the salt. Elephants do it. We humans don't, but you know, some, we are getting sick. Oh, and some animals eat it to help them digest, break down certain foods in their stomach that's hard to break down. I think fish do that. They swallow the gravel so it can help break down the food, and a lot of animals. We don't eat dirt because, you know, it's not clean, but maybe it's a deficiency. Maybe. I don't know everything. Don't know on this topic. Don't have much garlic today, but you can use up to 8 garlic cloves. You kind of smash them. I realize I smash easy with my thumb, so I just do that. Rinse these. I just rinse these. So let's dice them. It's going in first, it's going in second. Add one. Just gonna peel this off. Just the skin, this outer layer is the strongest, so you just wanna peel off this. It in half, half over here, half over there. Scallion and onion is like the same thing, so that's why I'm just using half. Onions have burned my eyes. Turnip, let's peel it. It's a turnip. I never used to cook with turnip in it. You know, my first book though, I've not one turnip in there. But you can use turnip with any beef.
Maybe cut it up. Half over there, half over here. It's a turning pair. Another thing with supermarkets I don't like that much. The tomato, onion, you know, stuff like those. You don't need to put them in the fridge. Some supermarkets do, and trust me, it's disgusting. Because maybe when you go home, you don't want to put it in a fridge, and not only when you put it in the fridge, it spoils quicker. Usually when I buy green stuff like these, I let them stay out, and they last me for at least a week. To meet in a second, I'd church and all. Leaves off. It's peerless. You can use all of it if you feel like. It's gonna break down lens. Nothing is wrong if you leave a little of the skin on it either too. You just cut this. Cut it out. Just dice it. Add one. Cut that out. Just dice it. Add two. Another one, dice this too. This tomato, add two. The pepper. Add one. Add two. Keep it here clean. Add herbs and rosemary. Like a teaspoon. Just grind it up fine. Use your black pepper grinder and just grind this up for you. And put half over here, half over here. This is parsley. 1 tablespoon. Half over here, half over there. This is good for juices, items, stew, and flavored. It's no meat. Oregano or oregano, a teaspoon. A teaspoon. Or half a teaspoon. It's kind of strong, so. Basil, no, we didn't. Dried or fresh. Any of these herbs, you can use them dry or fresh. Tablespoon. See, I keep them in bags, so don't make mess. Marjoram. A teaspoon. Marjoram. And this is basil, which we use already. And pimento berries. Teaspoon. Half over here. Half over there. Teaspoon. just like a quarter teaspoon of grated nutmeg in the first adding. So that's it. Let's cover this. I'm adding starfish because I choose to. I prepared it before and it was nice. But you don't have to. This can be straight stew. You don't have to have this. It's optional. Some starfish. And I'm going to use a small amount. Get under here. And separate the skin from the flesh. Just kind of hold it with your finger and just peel it off. Gently and slowly. Like that. All about the meat, your flesh, your fingers. Just get it off. That's it. So run this on the running water and rinse off the salt or soak it. This is for rainy days. Alright. Let's rinse this out. Rinse out the salt. And soak it. Now squeeze it. Squeeze it. This is just rinsing this out. Now, remove the bones. Debone it. Just kind of peel this out. Usually all the bones are one place. You just feel and pull it out. I went through, no bone. Alright, let's soak this in enough water and just soak it. The more water you put in, the more it will suck the salt out. But we don't want no salt in this thing. If any salt, this is all the salt. Right? So you just allow this to soak for about an hour or less. Half an hour less. So this is our peas soaking. Let's remove the water. This is what it looks like. Split apart. Add one. Make sure I add one this. That's 2 cups of coconut milk. 3 cups. fact, 3 cups. Make it 4 cups. Alright, so everything is added. Once it starts to whistle, we're going to time it for 20 minutes. Put the stove gauge on high, medium high, until it comes to whistle. Once it comes to whistle, then we're going to put it on low. Start kicking like Wanda. Put the stove gauge on low. And time it for 20 minutes. Alright, it's 20 minutes. And just allow it to cool. If you're in an hurry, just run water, tap water, over here and here until it releases. And then you open it. Take this off and then open it. But don't ever just take this off like this and let me push it. Don't do that. The flavor escapes if you do that. Just allow it to cool. Just allow it to cool. This is the saltfish. This is the saltfish soaking. Been soaking it for about 40 minutes now. That way all the salt is gonna come out. The meat look pretty. A second add. Right, it's cool. It took about 15-20 minutes to cool. Just allow it to get hot. Put your stove gauge on. And put a little coconut oil, about 2 tablespoons. This now, just remove the water. Kind of squeeze it out. Alright. Like this. Don't mince it up too much. It's like, you know, big chunks. This is the second add. Just take out a couple of the onions and the scallion. Couple, just a few. Piece of the chocha, maybe piece of the turnip. Alright. I'm at home, so sometimes I don't wear a shirt. But this way you're gonna do this, put on your shirt because it's gonna splash.
Dry up oil, but it's like it's going to be a coffee, so I don't want too much oil. After a minute and a half to cool. Seasoning is added, you're not adding any salt. Just use the pots lid and cover it properly. And put your stove gauge on low. You don't want to fast because this is coconut milk. If you fast cook it, it's going to get thick quick. So you just want to keep it on low so it simmers. Between low and half. This is what I'm eating it with green bananas. Because of the drought, it's almost summer, it's like spring now. Because of the drought, bananas, the price of bananas is getting high. A couple of the banana trees and planting trees are falling down. You're not gonna see this, I'm just showing it to you. If you wanna see this, visit my website, jamaicadinners.com. And just go to main menu, recipes, pick hundreds of recipes there. They may look dry. 10 minutes stewing. I'm gonna turn the stove up a little. Put it down low. I had
add it on very low. Why am I putting it on low? I want it to simmer. I want it to boil. See, I don't want to add no more liquid to this. We add 4 cups to pressure it and 2 more now to stew it, so that's 6.5. Don't want it to cook too fast now. So now that's boiling, I'm going to put it back on very low. It was on that. Don't want it that low. Keep it covered properly so that the steam stay in and simmer. That's my banana getting away. Almost done. Can't turn it off now. This is 20 minutes just boiling away. I'm just showing you, but I would normally keep it stove. I cook this all the while. It's delicious. It's nice. For those of you who don't eat meat, this is a nice way, and you love stew peas, this is a nice way to cook stew peas without meat. Even with the broad beans. With the broad beans, can I give it? You know what? I was here one day, and I saw the broad beans, and I saw the kidney beans, and I just whip up something. And the starfish was the only food I had. And when I done whip it up, and make it, it tastes good. So this is really a second video I'm making to show you guys what I did. Alright, it's 40 minutes now. I just left it, keep it on low, and just allow it to simmer. Simmer. Time stick, remove it. Just simmer. That was 40 minutes. I'll turn the stove up on low. Like the gate say low. See how it works. Okay, it's 45 minutes now since it's stewing. I'll explain something to you with coconut milk. With the pot covered, it's gonna cream, yes, but a secret, just like rundown, the secret, I'm about to open the pot and leave it open, and when it boils with it uncovered, it creamifies the stew. I'm gonna leave it open. 1 of the peas. Why we allowed it to stew? Because the beans are gonna suck up the stew flavor. So now turn the stove gauge up on medium. Medium high. Allow it to boil. Stove's gauge is on 6. It's like a little bit below medium. At medium high. had a few of the saltfish. Piece and I didn't fry that much. So it's 52 minutes stewing right now. Just to recap, the pressure cook the beans in 4 cups of coconut milk. But I recommend that you put 6 so that you have more. So that it don't dry up like it almost did, like you saw on the video. Like you saw earlier. And then we put add season with that. Then we allow it to pressure and cool. And then we add, then we fry this. And then we add a 2 cups of coconut milk. The seasoning, beans, and just cover it and allow it to simmer to now, which is going to be at 55 minutes. It's 53 minutes now. Once it starts to stick to the bottom, that's when it's a sign to say it's ready. And when the bubbles start to splash, it hit you boom in the face. I hope it didn't boom in the face, that finger I mean. Alright, why I had these now? Because when I add it this way, when you serve it, people are gonna taste the chunks of salt fish. If you had added it earlier, it would have probably soften out in this too. It's getting too thick now. So that was 55 minutes. See? Until you're ready to serve, like in 8 minutes the most, because once it cools it's gonna get thicker. Best time, serving time. This is what it looks like. Let's take a scoop. Salt fish stew peas. Vital food. Rastafarian food. Alright. It's also nice with rice. Like wheat brown rice. See you.